Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar. Today we are going to talk about from where you should not be buying milk. So first of all, you should not be buying packaged milk, I would say. The reason is that most of the packaged milk that people buy comes from big companies, and they really have to meet the demand of people to really create a good business for themselves. So what they end up doing, what some companies might end up doing is they will inject cows with hormones so that cows give more milk. These hormones come in our body through the milk and they harm us. I have talked about this in my previous video, problem with today's milk. Now the second is some companies might try to get milk from a pregnant cow for the whole 9 months. At this time, in the last few months of the pregnancy, the cow naturally does not give milk. So if you try to get milk from a cow in those months, the hormone levels of cow are really high, as much as 30 times high. So these hormones come to our body via milk, so they can be harmful for us. These big companies have to really create big business and meet the demand of people, so they use machine to milk the cow to get the efficiency to, because usually if you milk a cow by hand it will take 10 to 15 minutes. If you do it by machine it takes 3 to 4 minutes. So they use machine milking can be harmful. So again, and these this milk comes in plastic packings, so when the milk stays in the plastic, it gets some constituents of the plastic in it, and when we drink it, it is harmful for us. So you don't, that is another reason that you should not be drinking packaged milk in plastic. So basically you should not be drinking packaged milk, I would say. Try to avoid it. Second, if you're buying from a small company or a small milk seller, but that guy milks the cows through machine, try to avoid that milk. Don't buy that milk. Now the third thing is, you should not buy milk from a place where a lot of milks meet. So there are sellers who would buy milk from 10 milk sellers and gather it with themselves, and then they would sell it to the customer, to the individual customer. So let's say 10 milk sellers would come to the main milk seller and they would sell the milk. Let's say 7 out of them sold the right quality milk, the milk had no problem and it was milked by hands. But let's say the 3 out of the remaining 3 milk sellers, one had sold a chemically designed milk, so it will mix with all the rest of the milk, and you, even if you buy 1 liter milk out of that all milk, you get the chemicals in that milk. Similar is, let's say another seller injects hormones in his cows. Now that milk with hormones get mixed with all the milk. Now even if you buy half a liter of milk, that milk will have hormones in it. And let's say one seller mixed bad water in the milk to increase the quantity and took the cream out of the milk. So this dirty water would get mixed with all the milk, and even if you take 250 milliliters of milk, it would be harmful for your body. So basically try to avoid buying from a place where a lot of milks meet, a lot of milks get mixed, milks from different places get mixed. So try to avoid it. And then lastly, try to avoid milk from places that are not so trustworthy. So if you get your milk delivered at your home, you do not know what that guy is doing behind your back. If he is injecting hormones to the cows, if it is chemically designed milk, or if the cows are being milked through machine, or if the guy is pouring in dirty water, you do not know. And same is the case as when you go to buy milk from a milk shop. Even if that is not a packaged milk, if they are selling milk in open utensils, you do not know what they are doing behind your back. So I would say avoid buying from places that are not trustworthy, the places where you are not seeing what is happening through your own eyes. Okay, so why is it important to give so much weightage to milk? Because in a traditional Ayurvedic Indian diet, milk is said to be a very important part of our daily healthy diet. So you do not want it to be contaminated, first of all. And in our Indian diet, there are a lot of products that are made from milk, like curd, which is called as yogurt outside India, chhena or paneer, malai, which is the fat layer of milk, buttermilk, chhach, ghee, butter. These are made from milk, and these are make a really big part of our daily diet. So if your milk is contaminated, then all of these are going to be contaminated. So the right way is to get the right milk at your home and make all of these products at your home. You can make curd easily. If you're, let's say you have got the right milk at your home, now you can make curd easily. You can make chhena or paneer easily by making sour milk by using lemon or curd in the normal milk. I talked about this in my video separating protein, carbohydrates and fats of milk. Then you can get the malai out of the milk, the layer of fat on top of the milk. Then this is where people face problem, buttermilk, ghee and butter. So for this you need to do bilona of the milk. So you need to have that rotator which kind of rotates the curd in a utensil for like half an hour. So nowadays there are electric machines known as electric madani, where you do not have to put in manual effort. They'll rotate the rod for you electrically. So you would get your buttermilk and butter separated, and through the butter or malai you can make your ghee. So the ideal way would be to get the right milk at your home and make all the milk products at home, because if you try to buy curd from a shop, or paneer or malai or buttermilk or ghee or butter from a shop, you again do not know which milk has been used to make these products. But when you get the right milk at your home and you make these products at home, you know that these products have been made from the right milk. When you buy them from shop, you again do not know if they have been made from the contaminated milk or the right milk. And another reason to pay a lot of attention to the milk and milk products is that nowadays there are a lot of diseases that are flourishing. One is like silent heart attack. In earlier days there was a heart attack which would be like heart attack 1, heart attack 2, and in the third heart attack the person dies. Nowadays there is a silent death, and after the death doctor tells, oh, it was a heart attack. The person doesn't even come to know, the family members don't even come to know. The reason to these sort of diseases can be these chemicals or hormones or getting mixed in the milk, or the pesticides that are given to the fruits and vegetables in the agriculture, and they are injecting hormones to fruits or vegetables so that they grow overnight, so the business owners can get more sale. These hormones can be harmful for us. So we would want to avoid all of these things, and one important part or big part of our diet is milk. So you would want to get the right milk and make the milk products at your home from the right milk, to assure that all of these things are right and they would not harm the health of your family and you. So in the next video I will talk about from where you can buy milk. So if you like this video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.